This episode is sponsored by me and Light and Sound Media, where we teach you how to make better lighting and sound for your videos. First, there is no best microphone. There are too many factors that influence the quality of sound recordings. It would be like saying that a Lamborghini Revuelto is the best car. I'm not even sure I said that right. With respect, that would not be a good car for most day-to-day driving, and it would make a terrible SUV or pickup truck for towing a trailer. But if you're going to be on a track, looks like a pretty nice car. Same goes for microphones for recording audio. There are a ton of factors that define whether a particular microphone is the best for the particular circumstances you are going to be using it in. In the almost 20 years that I've been recording spoken word audio, I've learned something that I hope will help you as well. The piece of audio gear that makes the biggest difference in the quality of sound for your recordings is not a piece of gear. It's your skills. Your skill in choosing the mic to fit the situation, skill in positioning the microphone, skill in setting the gain, skill in post-production, these are the things that make a bigger difference in the quality of sound you achieve. So, I'm not going to tell you a lie that gear doesn't matter. Mics and recorders and wireless systems and audio interfaces are tools, and you need to use these tools to make recordings. But I get a lot of questions like this that I can't really answer. What's the best microphone? What's the best wireless microphone system? What's the best audio recorder? What's the best audio interface? And I wouldn't trust anyone, including me, to answer that with a specific piece of gear. If they don't know all the factors about your situation, do not trust that answer. Why? Because I, or any expert you ask, doesn't know the context of what you're trying to record, details about the location where you'll be doing the recording, what your budget is, what other equipment you're using, your skill level, how much post-processing you plan to do, how skilled you are at post-production. And all these things matter a lot when it comes to choosing a microphone. Let me give you an example. What's the best podcasting setup? One expert might answer a Neumann U87 AI and a Rupert Neve Designs Shelford channel. Now, if you don't even know what it is I just said, that's about $7,500 worth of audio gear. And that doesn't even include an audio interface to convert the audio to digital so you can get it into your computer. That could be an incredible setup for someone who dedicates themselves to learning how to use that gear. But here's the reality. Unless the person using it knows how to position the microphone, set gain, set a high pass filter, set EQ, set compression, and set up texture control on the Shelford channel, it very likely will not sound any better than a $300 kit that includes a basic microphone and a USB audio interface. But Curtis, how am I ever supposed to decide which microphone to buy? The reality is, you need to go on the audio learning journey. You have to start somewhere. You'll need to buy a microphone after doing a little bit of research. And I would do a little bit of research, not a ton of research. And the reality is, you may need to choose a different microphone, one that maybe fits your voice better, after you've worked with your first microphone for a while. Your first microphone may be the perfect fit for you, or like me, it may be a good microphone, but not a great fit. My first pro microphone was the Rode NT1A, and it's a good microphone, but my voice and that mic did not work well together. It overemphasized the sibilance in my voice, the shh, shh, those noises, but it is a good fit for those with darker, less sibilant voices. My wife's voice sounds fantastic on a Rode NT1A. So I suggest you learn by volunteering to help someone who knows how to record quality sound like you want to achieve. Tell them what you're trying to achieve and ask their advice on what gear to start with. But keep in mind, their starting suggestion may not be the latest and most feature-rich gear. Why? Because they know that skill is the most important thing. And their suggestion is probably for simple, quality gear that will help you achieve good recordings and not distract and confuse you with a ton of the latest features. So, for example, if someone who has no audio recording experience asked me, what's the best podcast setup? Well, first of all, I'd ignore the best part and I would answer what makes the most sense for a beginner to develop their skills, because developing those skills will make a much bigger impact on the quality of sound that they're able to record in the long run. And my answer would be a Shure SM58 microphone, a $5 foam cover for the microphone, a 10-foot Canary cable, microphone cable, and a Focusrite Scarlett 2i2 or a Motu M2 USB audio interface. And that would be a great place for almost any podcaster to start their journey and start to build their skills. You can make great spoken word audio recordings with that kit. In fact, in this video, I used that exact $300 kit. So, saddle up, friend. It's a great journey. There are a lot of great resources on YouTube and elsewhere to help you on your journey. I've listed a few of my favorite YouTube channels below to help you. Some are for beginners, some are for more advanced. But ideally, you have to get your hands dirty and get experience. An audio-only podcast is a good, low-risk way to start. You're not going to get rich making a podcast, especially an audio-only podcast, but it will give you the experience you need to start making fantastic sound. Get out there, make some great sound on your audio recording journey. Talk to you soon.